is the district that includes, well, the people in the district, Preston, Chesapeake, Eastern Shore. A few more notes coming in here. Megan McMorris said the video, this is again about that building of life, and it's on the show today. Video states how some people have so much, and some don't have enough, and that's not okay. And as an anti-poverty advocate who's been working in the school for over 10 years, he prefers to flag stigma attached to poverty, but this ad is calling for action on poverty. Megan, thank you for your take. We'll take a break, and when we return, we'll take up the issue of the former home for colored children from a former resident, Tony Smith.
You're listening to the Sheldon McLeod Show on Halifax's home for talk, News 95.7. We'll be back with more in a moment.
Planning and saving for your child's post-secondary education can be confusing. What is best for you? We'll guide you through. Hi, I'm Ken Chang, President and CEO. Our financial advisors are completely familiar with all the options. ESPs, Canada Education Savings Grants, Student Lines of Credit, and Student MasterCards. Together, we can make education possible and affordable. At East Coast Credit Union, enjoy a refreshingly honest way to bank. For a location near you, visit eastcoastcu.ca.
You walk all over it every day. Of course it gets dirty. I'm UFC fighter TJ Grant. Keeping your carpet clean is a real fight. And Deep Down Cleaning Services is here to battle the grime. Deep Down's truck-mounted system and 3D odorization gets to work and gets your carpet super clean. And now, Deep Down Cleaning Services does area rugs and car detailing, too. Drop them off for a deep cleaning at the Deep Down Cleaning Headquarters.
Deep Down Cleaning Services, 70 Crane Lake Drive in Bears Lake.
Happy Harry's is slashing prices in a major way for their Black Friday sale tomorrow and Saturday. Don't miss out on deals like all-in-stock countertops, now just $5 a foot. 25% off regular priced area rugs, trims, and moldings. Select porcelain tile, 50% off. Interior doors with fast fit frame, only $89 each. The Black Friday sale, tomorrow and Saturday at Happy Harry's. Burnside in Dartmouth and Bears Lake, Halifax. Happy Harry's. Renovate. Appreciate.
East Coast Credit Union offers the financial advice, products, and services you need for every single stage in life. From first jobs, apartments, and cars, to second incomes, homes, and kids. Making sense of your money should be as easy as 1, 2, 3.
Whether you're 16 or 116, East Coast Credit Union is here to help. Visit eastcoastcu.ca to find your nearest location and connect with one of our financial experts today.
Sometimes controversial, always engaging. It's the Rick House Show. Weekday mornings from 9 to 12:30. It's your chance to have your say. Join Rick for fascinating interviews, thoughtful insights, and the news you need to know about our province. It's the best way to start your work day. The Rick House Show. Every weekday morning starting at 9. Brought to you by Colonial Honda on Roby, your Halifax Honda dealer, and your number one station for news, talk, sports. News 95.7.
and we have met you. Sorry for what has happened to the driver at this point. That is my point of time. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir. We appreciate it.
That's all our time. We're a few of you, so feeding back with some of your pictures online and some comments about the small town drive question, please. Producer Matt, thank you.
No problem. Just taking calls with the one or two calls, but when the road, someone would step up. It's probably horrible everywhere. Just be careful.
Take your time, and we'll be back tomorrow at 12:30. On the show.
Join us for the Sheldon McLeod Show, weekdays from 12:30 to 3:30 on News 95.7.
Brought to you by Atlantic Acura on the Bedford Highway. It has to be Acura.
Hi, this is Clinton Wilkins. Homeownership is part of the Canadian dream. It's the biggest purchase of your life, and it's the biggest debt of your life, too. There are many features, pricing, and rates that differ from lender to lender. Mortgage brokers are really your best solution. We have access to up to 40 different lenders. We do the research, and we're able to give you expert advice. And we're excited to be able to help the people who live here in Halifax and Atlantic Canada obtain their dreams of homeownership. Find out more today at teamclinton.ca/radio.
Winter is on its way, but that's no longer something to worry about during the Honda Power Through Winter event at Maritime Lawn and Garden. Right now, get big savings and great value on select Honda snowblowers and generators designed to take on virtually anything winter throws your way in a cold snap. Give winter the cold shoulder during the Honda Power Through Winter event at Maritime Lawn and Garden. For details, visit honda.ca/winter.
Forget Black Friday. It's Bling Weekend at Inglis Jewelers. A sale with so much bling, they can't fit it all in one day. Today, tomorrow, and Saturday, save 20% off almost everything in store at Inglis Jewelers. Plus, spend $200 and you'll get a free pair of diamond earrings while supplies last. 20% off almost all the bling and free diamonds for 3 days only, and only at Inglis Jewelers, 66 Inglis Place, Truro. Don't go blingless. Go to Inglis.
Looking for a pre-owned car? Look no further than Dartmouth Dodge. Drop in today and check out their awesome selection of certified pre-owned vehicles. Dartmouth Dodge features more than 80 price-to-sell cars at all, starting as low as $6,000. And they offer most makes and models. They'll even buy your vehicle, even if you're not looking to buy one. See the complete inventory online at ddodge.com or stop in today. Dartmouth Dodge, where Nova Scotia comes to save.
Number one for breaking news, traffic, and weather. This is News 95.7 Halifax.
Here are Steve MacArthur and Sky Bledingale.
Good afternoon. It is Thursday, November 28th. Police say driving conditions are deteriorating as snow continues to build on roads in and around Halifax.
An inquiry into decades of abuse at the Nova Scotia Home for Colored Children has submitted its final report to the province after 4 years of study. The inquiry calling for the creation of an independent children and youth commission.
The Nova Scotia government has provided an estimated cost for crane removal that fell over during Hurricane Dorian back in September.
We're in the vicinity of $2 million.
Halifax Water has been approved to spend more than $10 million to speed up the replacement of thousands of lead service lines.
We're looking at filing a general rate application early 2020, and pilot application would be this new program.
It's game night for the Mooseheads as they visit the Acadie Bathurst to tan. The Montreal Canadiens meet the Devils. There are three matchups for American Thanksgiving in the NFL. Sports at 45.
One Canadian Games producer has unveiled its lineup of next-gen pop products. TSX up by 8 points, eyeing another record closing high. The Wall Street's closed for a holiday. Business at 56.
News 95.7 time, 3:31.
And time for Carson Exports, traffic and weather together on the ones. And now with Halifax's most frequent traffic reports, here's Ashlyn Schufelt.
Thanks, Steve. We're seeing heavy congestion all over Halifax and the outlying areas on the highways because of the weather. RCMP are warning people to slow down and drive with caution. Also, make sure that your headlights are on. There's a collision on the 102 outbound after by the Hammond's Plains Road exit, backing up traffic in that area. We're also seeing that the power is out in Bedford as well as Lower Sackville. Use traffic lights as a four-way stop. There's also word on Twitter of cars struggling to get up hills and fender benders on city streets. So please drive with caution while you get home and expect delays. If you see any problems on the road or have any updates, give us a call hands-free at 902-493-7184. Now with your weather forecast, here's weather specialist John Wilson.
Rain has turned to snow even for the city now. You can see what we've got here. And it doesn't take much, just 1 degree drop, and all that liquid goes to snowflakes, and here we are. The airport's got a few centimeters already, as expected, but zero tonight. Looks like this will end overnight, but partly sunny tomorrow comes with a cold north wind, and we'll be lucky to get off the zero mark at 2 degrees and then drop again. Flurries tomorrow night, and then a chance of flurries and sunny breaks Saturday, -1. Tonight's low is zero.
Right now in downtown Halifax, 1 degree. At the airport, it's zero. We'll have another chunk of traffic and weather together in less than 10 minutes. News 95.7 time, 3:34.
Health police are warning drivers to slow down as snow is building on roads in and around Halifax.
Our newsroom is being flooded with phone calls reporting vehicles spinning tires and off the road in some cases. Halifax Regional Police spokesperson John McLeod says the driving conditions are challenging.
Well, yeah, it's just the temperatures dropped a little lower than they had expected, so we're starting to get that near freezing weather. It is that time of year. We hope folks have their winter tires on, and knowing that the weather has turned a little typical Nova Scotia, we're getting a little bit of everything. Now people need to take a little more time to get where they're going.
In Timmer, CFP say traffic is also slow moving on the 100 series highways due to the snowfall. They posted photos showing a busy stretch of Highway 102 near the airport is currently snow covered. Environment Canada has updated its forecast, now saying 5 to 10 centimeters of snow expected to fall in HRM. And looking at Nova Scotia Power's outage map, currently 20,000 customers impacted by power outages at this hour, and we'll update you on that situation throughout the afternoon. A restorative inquiry into decades of abuse at the Nova Scotia Home for Colored Children has submitted its final report today. The inquiry calling for the creation of an independent Children and Youth Commission. News 95.7's Chris Halak with more.
The Nova Scotia Home for Colored Children opened in 1921 and closed its doors in 1978. Now it became a symbol of the province's ongoing struggle with institutional racism and discrimination. Former resident Tony Smith says it's important to educate youth about Black history.
Education is very important. I went to school, there's nothing that we learned about our Black history. To have the youth look at this particular card and the way that they respond to this and how they commend us former residents for coming forward, it's really empowering.
Speaking at a press conference, Premier Stephen McNeil says it's important all institutions accepted collective responsibility before moving forward.
And that's an important journey that we're on. I want to tell you I am committed to dealing this report, dealing with the issue of counterfeiting and the issue of systemic racism in our province.
The inquiry calls for a fundamental shift in the way the province's institutions deal with racism and institutionalized abuse. Chris Halak, News 95.7.
The Nova Scotia Power says Hurricane Dorian back in September. Says the cost of removing a construction crane that toppled in downtown Halifax during Hurricane Dorian is at least $2 million. The Nova Scotia government is now assessing how to recover those costs. News 95.7's Matthew Moore has details on that.
Transportation Minister Lori Hines says this is close to what the final cost will be, as the province is still gathering some final invoices related to the project. Hines told reporters today the next steps we'll be discussing is to recover this money.
Then from there on,
when asked about possibly suing the crane operator, Hines says he hopes the government wouldn't have to take that path, saying options are being weighed.
Well, reasonable people make reasonable judgments, right? And that's where we start.
It's been just over a month since the last piece of crane was removed from the building on South Park Street. The crane originally collapsed on September 7th, falling onto a building as post-tropical storm battered the region. Matt.
Matthew Moore, News 95.7.
Halifax Water has been given approval by its Board of Commissioners to speed up the replacement of thousands of private lead service lines. This comes after a report revealed nearly a third of tap water tests conducted by Halifax Water since 2012 exceeded the national guideline for lead content. We get more on that from News 95.7's Katie Hurtado.
There reports of collaborative investigation by nine universities and 10 media organizations, including Global News, Star Halifax, and the University of King's College. Today, Halifax Water's board approved a request for an additional $10.5 million to accelerate the replacement of underground pipes that deliver drinking water from water mains to homes. James Campbell is a spokesperson for Halifax Water and says the Nova Scotia Utility and Review Board still has to approve the plan. He tells the Sheldon McLeod Show an application will be submitted early next year.
It's a great day because the time right now we're looking at the future, maybe Halifax Water taking over full responsibility for the replacement of the private and public service lines, but again, that will be determined by the regulator next year.
He says the proposed program will replace about 3,500 private lead pipes over the course of about 20 years. That's about 24 years earlier than originally projected. Campbell says he expects there will be rate increases for customers.
Scotia's health minister says his government is set to make changes to vaping regulations as early as next week. Randy Gallori says current legislation allows government to make regulatory changes when it comes to vaping flavors. He says more sweeping changes will require new legislation, which could be introduced during the spring sitting of the legislature. Gallori says his government will consider recent changes to vaping in both Prince Edward Island and British Columbia.
We're seeing heavy congestion all over Halifax and the outlying areas on the highways because of the weather. RCMP are warning people to slow down and drive with caution. Also, make sure that your headlights are on. We're seeing that power is out in Bedford and Lower Sackville. If you do come across a set of traffic lights, use as a four-way stop. Also, there's word on Twitter of cars struggling to get up hills, stalled vehicles, fender benders on the city streets. So please drive with caution while you get home and expect delays. Get ready for the TSC's Black Friday blowout. Save up to 60% on electronics, jewelry, and more all weekend long. It all starts tonight at 10 p.m. at tsc.ca. Now with your weather forecast, here's weather specialist John Wilson.
Well, it all turned to snow. One little degree, and that's what happens. It was supposed to be snowing then, and indeed, the airport has a few centimeters now. And the city's getting it, too. And as long as the temperature stays this way, that's what we'll get, at least until it quits later this evening. And the temperature will stay pretty close to zero for the time being. Now tomorrow it's supposed to get to 2 degrees. I'm not sure it's going to do that. It should clear to some sun, but there are a chance of flurries late, and it'll be a cold north wind, and the whole thing is kind of miserable. -1 on Saturday with some flurries and sunny periods, and 0 on Sunday. Tonight's low is 0.
Right now in downtown Halifax, it is 1 degree, sitting at 0 at the airport. Remember, News 95.7 is the only radio station with a weather guarantee. And the City Best Weather Guarantee Contest is underway today. Join us at the guaranteed high at 3 in the jackpot, $625. To enter the City Best Weather Guarantee Contest, just head to news957.com and follow the links. News 95.7 time, 3:43. President of the Nova Scotia Teachers Union says this week's arbitration decision to allow specialists to be part of the union is a huge win for teachers and students. Paul Wasney telling News 95.7 the provincial government tried to force future psychologists, social workers, and speech-language pathologists out of the union. News 95.7, Steve Heinzman with more.
Sloan's decision concluded the education department violated the collective agreements in numerous respects. According to his understanding, Wozniak says the government can only challenge the decision on judicial terms. That is, if there's something unsound about how the decision was made.
But they can't challenge the content of the decision. And of course, we've seen, this government has been prepared to use the legislature for any number of actions that end up in a charter challenge. So we sincerely hope that the government is prepared to respect a sound legal decision by an arbitrator.
Wozniak says this is a testament to how good things are possible when teachers stick together to fight for what's right for them and their students. Dave Heinzman, News 95.7.
And still to come,
Andrew Scheer under fire. The conservative leader is vowing to keep fighting on in his role as more influential Tories call out for his resignation.
News 95.7 time, 3:45.
How Bell makes Black Friday better.
How can I help you?
Well, our little trooper wants a tablet, Finn wants a smartwatch, and Ray would love a new phone.
Great. We have amazing offers on devices, and they're connected to the best network in the galaxy.
Get any phone for $0 down with Bell Smart Pay. Paid over 24 months with 0% APR and an eligible 2-year rate plan. Plus, get epic offers on smartwatches, tablets, and more. Additional charges apply. Visit a Bell Alliance store or bell.ca/Black Friday. Bell, Black Friday just got better. See Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker in theaters on December 19th.
Trouble sleeping? Constantly tired? Do you snore? You may have sleep apnea. Weak.
Neurology. I claimed to sell his bond, and he ran for president in 1992.
Let's put it back to back.
He did not do well in Democratic primaries, but ran on the general election in states that allowed imprisoned candidates.
Sure.
He got the second fewest votes nationally of any candidate.
Imagine being the last. I really should not be in politics, and that's all this is saying.
He was released in January 1994, and yet, in the 1996 Democratic primaries, he won enough votes in Louisiana and Virginia to get delegates at the national convention. The party instructed states to disregard his votes, so no convention delegates voted for him. In 2000, he runs for president again, and he gets 22% of the vote in the Arkansas Democratic primary. This gave him 6 delegates at the convention, and the National Party again refused to allow his delegates. And then came 9/11, when Lyndon took a strong stand against the Bush administration, especially Dick Cheney, and with his huge opposition to the Iraq War, this activism created a big presence on college campuses and brought him in many new young recruits. So it's a classic quote. A member said, leaders, quote, were constantly asking us if we would die for these ideas. Every morning at 8 a.m., the followers at the Virginia compound would sing old slave spirituals, followed by hearing apocalyptic news briefing from Lyndon or another leader, and then they'd spend the day fundraising and recruiting until 10 p.m. In 1904, Lyndon ran for president.
In 2004.
Sorry, 2004, he ran for president. He told his followers, quote, I have a better chance of being elected than you have of surviving if I'm not.
That's cool to hear.
Best campaign slogan ever.
Awesome. All right, yeah. Do it or we're going to die. We're going to die.
Can't you see Trump saying that?
Yeah.
Yeah. In 2008 and 2012 elections, Lyndon went after Obama, calling him, quote, the new Hitler, which is weird because he likes Hitler, but, you know.
Right, yeah.
He called climate change a hoax. They disrupted environmental rallies. They spent 2016 mocking Trump. Quote, he's a festering pustule on Satan's rump. Don't you be a chump for Trump, they would chant at it.
Rhymes a bunch.
But after Trump won, Lyndon praised Trump's, quote, intent to end the policies of British imperial free trade and make a full commitment to industry, manufacturing, and scientific advancement and world peace. Roger Stone spoke at a Lurish convention.
Of course.
And then Lyndon began suffering from dementia. He started posting YouTube videos that were nonsensical, like even more nonsensical than they right. would be. One example, quote, we are about to do a job on the study of China with the idea of the development of the back of the moon. The back of the moon is very specific kind of physical principle, but that principle, when properly understood, will change the history of mankind. On February 12th, 2019, Lyndon LaRouche died at the age of 96.
When?
February 12th.
Wow.
2019. His followers refused to tell the media the location and the cause of his death.
Jesus Christ.
How do you feel?
I don't know. Not good, but I do know, I mean, you know that, like, you're right. I think that everybody treats Trump like an anomaly. Like, how did this happen? And then there are just so many little things that...
Never been here.
Yeah, and clearly there has... been a history of this sort of...
That's right. People act like Reagan wasn't... Reagan was incredibly similar to this.
Yeah.
I mean, aside from the crazy sexual stuff...
his whole thing was Make America Great Again.
He put a wreath on a Nazi's grave.
Right, yeah.
He did the Star Wars shit. Like, Reagan was out of his fucking mind, and so were the people around him, and it was very similar.
Yeah. Yeah. It's cool.
It was cool.
It was a cool time.
I just want to say, I'm going to read this. We're going to talk a little bit.
I just can't. I just can't. It's like, it's also got a little bit of a hint of Tea Party to it, too.
It does.
Like, with the sense of extremely organized, playing to, you know, a section, and being very, very fucking aggressive. And, you know, that works.
Yeah.
There are so many factions today that it's like, it's hard to even know. I mean, it still is crazy that we're represented by two.
But that's just the way the system is. You're never going to get away from that. You're listening to the dark.
couple of centimeters here, maybe two or three or four. The airport already has that much, and we'll get more before it ends this evening. So a special weather statement for all of this, and besides it's windy, and the temperature is not performing well at all. It'll stay near zero. And then tomorrow we're supposed to get to 2 degrees and then drop. I'm not sure we're going to get off the zero mark. It'll be cloudy with sunny breaks tomorrow and flurries late, and windy, so there'll be a chill there. Stiff northwest wind on Saturday, sunny breaks and flurries, minus one. Also Sunday, partly sunny and zero. Lights low, zero.
And right now in downtown Halifax, it is 1 degree 0 at the airport. News 95.7 has traffic and weather together every 10 minutes on the ones at 1, 11, 21, 31, 41, and 51 minutes past the hour. Recapping our lead story this afternoon, police are warning drivers to slow down as snow and slushy conditions make for tricky driving conditions in and around Halifax. We'll have the latest on this, plus a traffic update as well. Other top stories coming up at the top of the hour with Sky Guard at home, News 95.7 time, 3:54. Thank you.